that was a fabulous event leading us to the showstopper of tonight. Leoni leo, asemae kesho ni muongo, sare tumekuja kupati. Now that's just a mashup of some of the best songs by Issa that have been playing on your radio 10 years after his demise after a tragic road accident in the year 2003. Well, we spoke to a couple of celebrities and artists just to find out why, even after 10 years of his missing in action in the entertainment industry, his presence is still felt. And we filed the following feature for you. Check it out.
Even after his demise, the late teenage hip-hop idol Issa, fame and fortune still follows him 7 years to his tragic death. Issa was born Issa Murray in May 20th, 1981 in California Estate, studied at St. Anne's Junior Academy and later attended high school at Brookhouse Senior School. And it was during high school that he started rhyming and writing poetry, initially for fun. It was until 1998 that he decided to take his music seriously. In 1999, he met DJ Luke of the music production house Ogopa DJs and began his recording career.
He used to record in other studios, but not known studios. I think with Big Pin, if I'm not wrong, and K-Rapt, they came along, they were like, can you listen to our stuff? Whatever they had as a demo, and it impressed the producers. And they took up the whatever from there. Then, in fact, the first song that was done, it was average, but clearly as a producer or a talent scout, you'll tell there's talent there. So guys decided, let's take this guy and nurture him. That's how everything started.
Towards the end of 2002, Issa released his much-awaited debut album titled Nimefika. And 2 years on, it became the most popular urban contemporary album in East Africa. Virtually all the released singles from the album topped East Africa charts. Sadly, A Candle in the Wind, Issa passed away on Sunday, March 16, 2003, on his way home after a performance in Nakuru the previous evening.
I was a student at Kampala when Issa and Nameless had started coming up. So I really, really respected them because I saw myself doing music like later on in life, and it was an inspiration. So there's the aspect of me dancing to the music and them giving me an inspiration. That's the biggest memory I have of them.
The album Nimefika is by far the most successful album by a local artist in recent years. The music, the lyrics, and the style of the album was such that it reached out to people of all ages and touched everyone in a special way.
That guy rocked my teenage life. Yeah.
It's alikuwa creative, alikuwa mtu anasoma mind za watu, alikuwa mtu anafanya vitu zinaeleweka, sawa?
Issa broke the ground, man, for us, and he was a pioneer. Him alongside kina Nameless, Kleptomaniacs, all those guys. So as much as we might not talk about them right now, we really looked up to them in a way. They broke the grounds. It's because of them that we were able to do what we did. And it's because of us that other people in the future will be able to do, you know, hip-hop, be able to do gospel hip-hop and look big. So someone has to go out there, be a pioneer, you know, be the first at something, and yeah, they'll build the industry.
In character, his humility touched many fans, especially the teenagers and small children who almost lined up for his autograph after a performance, an appearance, or even when he was up and about in his neighborhood. Issa believed in himself, his music, and his abilities as a performing artist, a fact that people who worked with him can attest and ask fellow artists to emulate.
Nairobi! I can hear you! Mission Econo, respect to my boy Issa.
For me, every time I get a chance when I'm on stage and all that, I feel like I'm with him, you know. And I don't want people to forget, you know. Because I would not want to be forgotten also if I pass away. I would want someone to keep saying, you know. Because wherever I'll be watching. I don't want people to remember, hey, I was there, you know. So I always feel the same thing. I would want someone to do that, and I feel that, yeah.
Alikuwa ni mtu alianzisha hii industry, unajua, so hatujui vile angekuwa saizi industry ingekuwaje, but mimi najua vile alikuwa na yeye ndo alifanya sahihi mpaka mtukaa sisi tunafanyia muziki. Hao ndo alianzisha.
Isa alifungua njia. Rest in peace, bro.
Industry peeps are all up in my business claiming that I am changing the game. If that is so, I think Kenyans have long been awaiting the change. I love my hood, my friends, my family, and my fans. I love my life. Live it or leave it. It's a choice. Words by the legend that was and still is Issa.